As the national conversation continues about race relations and racial injustice, the issue is also moving into the political arena.
Big Two's Felice Romero reached out to District 11 candidates in Texas to see what their part is in this national conversation. Felice.
Katie, District 11 candidate John Mark Hoag says he has four important steps in mind that would have both a short and long-term positive impact on the black community in America.
We have to have these discussions to show, you know, that we're standing shoulder to shoulder with our black brothers and sisters.
Congressional District 11 candidate John Mark Hoag says it's time for political candidates to step up and create steps to move forward to a more just society. If elected, he wants to reform four key parts of the legal system. The first, mandatory sentencing guidelines.
Mandatory sentencing guidelines that have been in use for a long time. These don't give the judge really any discretion as far as deviating from it, going below if the circumstances warrant it. That's an issue of fairness, not just for black Americans, although it negatively impacts them because it results in a large number of people spending a lot of time in prison.
He says he also wants to look into giving defendants the choice to have their punishment decided by a jury and not the judge.
Giving defendants the option to have a jury. A lot of reforms that we're talking about, a lot of that is going to be, we're going to be depending a lot on the local and state governments. I believe in local control and they need to make those decisions.
According to Hoag, another part of the conversation is for-profit prisons, who are motivated by profit and not rehabilitation.
Getting rid of private prisons and detainment centers where you have a whole industry motivated by profit that profits off of more people being in prison than being out.
He says the First Step Act that was signed by President Donald Trump, which lessens some mandatory sentences, is a good first step. But it is still important to continue to push for a more racially just society for all.
What we really have to do is, as a white society, has to put as much effort into eradicating those vestiges of slavery and Jim Crow and discrimination and racism as we did into promoting slavery and the Jim Crow laws in the first place.
We did reach out to August Pfluger, his Republican opponent, multiple times to see how he would address racial injustice and have not heard back with a comment. Reporting live in studio, Felice Romero, Big 2 News.